teacher I appreciate the most has to be Ms. Valdez, because to be honest, she helps me out when I need problems. Like if I have any problems, she finds the solution to that problem, and she just helps me out in school.
The teacher I appreciate the most is Ms. Felipe, because she's a very funny and charismatic teacher, and she actually cares about helping out others and not just always worrying about herself. Like if I have a problem with something, she'll try to help me out, try to make me a better student. And yeah,
I think Teacher Appreciation Week is important because throughout the year, the teachers don't really get the love and the deserve. So I think this week is the perfect week for that love that they're missing out in this whole year.
I think Teacher Appreciation Week is important because it gives a little bit of that recognition to teachers who can sometimes feel a little bit overwhelmed. I would say that it's effective. It's nice to get letters from your students, remembering dumb jokes that you made, or them telling you how you have assisted them, or what their favorite part of your class is. There's never really a forum for that in the classroom unless you make it, so it's nice to get it from kids, and the fact that it's a specific week makes it more, I guess, special.
On Monday at 5:26 a.m., Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, and Prince Harry welcomed their first child to the British royal family. The yet-to-be-named baby boy is the first interracial baby in the British monarchy's recent history. The newborn baby is now seventh in line to the throne and is Queen Elizabeth II's eighth great-grandchild. This past Tuesday, the New York Times claimed to have obtained Donald Trump's tax information, including printouts from his official IRS tax transcripts for 1985 through 1994. The IRS receipts showed he lost money every year during the 10-year period, with total losses of $1.17 billion overall. The New York Times also stated he didn't pay income taxes for 8 of those 10 years. Donald Trump responded to the report swiftly on Wednesday, tweeting, "You always wanted to show losses for tax purposes. Almost all real estate developers did, and often renegotiate with banks. It was sport." And claims the report by the New York Times to be a quote-unquote fake news hit job. Donald Trump remains the only president from the presidency of Richard Nixon to now to not have released their tax returns. On Monday night, interest in the Sandra Bland case was reignited. To the public, it was revealed Sandra Bland, a 28-year-old African-American woman from the Chicago area, recorded her encounter as Trooper Brian Insignia threatened her with a stun gun during a 2015 traffic stop. The new release video has resulted in Mrs. Bland's family to call for a renewed investigation into her arrest and death from nearly 4 years ago. The video severely challenges a statement of Mr. Insignia regarding his safety being in quote-unquote jeopardy. Sandra Bland's case is quite often considered a turning point in the Black Lives Matter movement.
On April 25th, the Braddock baseball team won their game against South Dade Senior High School with a score of 8-5. On May 1st, the team played a tough game against Corey Senior High with a score of 5-8, finishing 4th in the district. The guys took another victory against Columbus in the semifinals with a score of 3-2. We all wish good luck to the guys in their upcoming games. The track team went to states and absolutely dominated. Paula Ben-Cosme reached top 10 in the 800 meter and even broke her own school record. Jordan Ford achieved in making first time state qualifier for the 3200 meter run. Lisa Ajwabi is also a 3-time qualifier for the mile. Congratulations to these amazing athletes.
This is the Marvel Universe recap. In the beginning, Tony Stark, the genius billionaire, became Iron Man after being kidnapped. After saving the world from his boss, Nick Fury, head of S.H.I.E.L.D., convinced Tony Stark to join the Avengers. After Iron Man 1, Iron Man is challenged by Ivan Vanko, where Iron Monger and Black Widow are introduced. Then Bruce Banner turns into the Hulk and fights the Abomination. After that time, Thor crash-landed. After being banished to Earth, he found his hammer and defeated his brother Loki. After that, Nick Fury finds Captain America trapped in ice, who defeated Hydra back in World War II. We find out that Loki is back with vengeance and Fury assembles the Avengers. After fighting the Chitauri, they defeat Loki again. The Avengers split up, with Iron Man having PTSD from the New York battle, Thor fighting an evil elf from claiming Asgard, and Loki seems to die. Nick Fury is shot by S.H.I.E.L.D., who infiltrated Hydra, and having Captain America fight off the Winter Soldier or his old best friend Bucky. With Cap, Widow, and a new friend, Falcon, they defeat Hydra and S.H.I.E.L.D. is disbanded. We find a new group of heroes, now with Captain of the Pirate Space Crew, going by the name of Star-Lord. He steals a mysterious glowing orb from the man named Ronan the Accuser. We later find out that Ronan is working with Thalnos, a galactic tyrant. We are introduced to the Infinity Stones at this time, along with the fact that Thalnos is looking for them. Star-Lord gathers up his crew and names them the Guardians of the Galaxy. They stop Ronan from laying waste to the planet Zondar using the Infinity Stone. Groot sacrifices himself to save the team, after which a baby Groot is regrown. Ultron is created by Tony and Bruce to act as a global security system, but it gains sentience and tries to destroy the world. Vision is created in the same way Ultron was, and in an ensuing battle against Ultron, a city named Sokovia is demolished. After witnessing the destruction laid upon Sokovia, the UN attempts to place restrictions on the Avengers, ultimately splitting the groups into two factions, Iron Man's side, which agrees with the UN, and Captain's side, which does not. During this time, more heroes are recruited to the Avengers, namely Spider-Man, Black Panther, and Ant-Man, in order to prepare for the ensuing civil war between the two factions. After a large battle, Captain America and Bucky fight against Iron Man, who discovers that Bucky, under mind control, killed his parents. While this is occurring, Thor's home planet of Asgard is destroyed by a flaming demon and his goddess sister, forcing the entire population to retreat to space, looking for a new home. While cruising through space, the ship is intercepted by Thanos, who easily defeats the Hulk and steals the Tesseract from Loki, giving two Infinity Stones. Thanos then quickly retrieves two more stones. He gets one from his minions, who ambush Doctor Strange, and he gets the other one after he reaches the Reality Stone sooner than the Guardians of the Galaxy. Later, Spider-Man and Iron Man save Doctor Strange to meet up with the Guardians to discuss their game plan while waiting for Thanos on his home planet of Titan. Thanos then retrieves the Soul Stone by sacrificing Gamora. After getting his fourth stone, Thanos goes to Titan and is ambushed by the superheroes laying in wait. He narrowly defeats the heroes and reveals his master plan, using the power of the Infinity Stones to halve the population of the universe in order to stop overpopulation. Thanos then uses the Time Stone from Doctor Strange in his gauntlet, giving him five stones. Thanos then goes to Earth as his army is invading Wakanda, fights the Avengers in an epic battle, defeats them, and then takes the Mind Stone that was implanted in Vision's head, giving him the final stone. Thanos then snaps his fingers and half of the universe's population vanishes. What will the Avengers do next? Find out in Avengers Endgame.
Hit it.
This side to the wall.
Run a low, you get hit. Can we nip it with a stick? Can we nip it with a key? I get that money like blow. I'm in it with a little meat. I do this shit in my sleep. Shawty tell me she's so geek. Shawty for me, she's so geek. I'm in it, bitch, and I'm fleet. I put VVs on my links.